Welcome to day four. Today we'll be stitching a dahlia using a 10 spoke, spoke easy, and I will be introducing you to silk and ivory and soft cotton.
Well, this is silk and ivory, and it is a 50% silk and 50% wool thread. It is so soft to stitch with and has a lovely sheen. It comes all the way from Switzerland. So this is what I have done my yellow double cast-ons with over here. Come in really pretty colors. So it's really a fun thread to work on wool because it just slides through beautifully. This is soft cotton. And so what I like about the difference in texture between the two is soft cotton is a matte, not very highly twisted at all thread, a little bit like a sashiko thread. So the difference between a pearl cotton and a sashiko thread is that a pearl cotton is a surface thread, so it actually sits up on the surface, whereas a sashiko thread is a thread that blends into the fabric. So those of you that have done a lot of my work know that I use a lot of sashiko threads for background stitching. And what I love about it is that it becomes part of the background more than sits on top as a surface thread. Painter's threads come in beautiful colors. When I talk about texture thread, it's about what the thread content is as well as how they dyed. So the difference between Alleganza threads and, for instance, painter's threads is that Alleganza is, it's dyed in the factory and it has repetitive, like 2 to 3 inch variegations, which is fabulous, but it has a different texture when stitched with painter's threads. Painter's threads, I always tell my students, say, like, put them all out lying flat, and then they paint them with different colors and then sort of splash them. And so every so often you might get a little orange stitch. It's sort of random. So it makes for a very nice texture when you stitch with them. This is more like a size 3 thread, the soft cotton, and is also a beautiful thread to stitch through wool. It's very soft, comes through very easily, and makes beautiful stitches. So I've used the soft cotton to do the spokes and the whipped woven circle right here in the center. And you can see if you look at the different luster in, this is silk and ivory, which has a sheen because of the silk. This is pearl cotton, which also has a sheen, but this has a much matter, flatter look, which is really fun within all the textures you use on wool. Okay, so for the dahlia, we're going to use the 10 spoke, spoke easy. And I'm just going to illustrate it on this paper so you can see what we're going to do. So we're going to mark the 1.5 inch mark, which is the last one on each of these spokes, like this. And don't forget the center, like that. We're then going to rotate it so that it's in the center of those marks now, and we're going to mark on the 3/4 inch mark over here. So each one of those at 3/4 inch. So that one's at 1.5. And the inside one is at 3/4 inch. Okay, so we're going to start by doing a fly stitch, and I did my fly stitch with soft cotton in Grandma Moses. And what I did was I made my V, so the center point of my V sitting on that dot, and then I came into the center like this. So you're going to stitch all of those first like this, all the way around. Okay, and then once we've done that, we're going to do a whipped woven circle. So a whipped woven circle is where you go back over one, under that one, under the next one, back over one, under that, under the next one. So the video is on Instagram, so if you're not familiar with it, make sure you look for it. And we're going to whip woven, so around for about a half an inch, like that. We will then couch the rest of these spokes. We will do a double cast on in each of these, and I use my silken ivory for that. And then I came back and put a little fly stitch using the base of the dot. And this time I made all these come to the center. Okay, so if you look at my piece, you can see the second set of fly stitches, which is on the 3/4 inch markings. Make sure that the V is at the base of the dot. And what I did here was I brought them into the center of the whipped woven circle so that it overlaps the circle, and it gives sort of a nice effect because it looks like little bullion knots in between from the whipped woven. And then in each one of these I did an oyster stitch, so I used a size 5, so it looks it gives it some body, which is nice. And then I finished with using a size 5 with French knots up at the top here. So, you know, one of the things I always talk about in my class is, you know, I'll have a lot of students say, oh, no, colonial knots are much neater than French knots. And I always say, well, I really disagree with that. I think most people who say that don't know how to do a good French knot. So I will just explain. When you do a French knot, you bring your thread up, you wrap towards your fingers twice, put your needle down, and before you pull your thread to the back, you want to hold that thread very taut at the bottom. And then that will give you a nice, neat French knot. So I thought I'd recap a little bit. We've used the Spoke Easy tool twice now with two different effects. And the more I play with them, the more fun I have. So yesterday we did a uneven amount of spokes. So with uneven, you always have to do a woven center. So you need an uneven amount of spokes to go over under in order to do that. With a whipped woven, you can do either with the even or uneven, but it gives a totally different look. The other thing is it by starting the fly stitch on the dot, it made a larger flower. And the other thing is how these have come into the center, changed the whole appearance of the center of the flower. So we'll be playing with them a little bit more, but have fun and see what you can come up with. Just a little bit about the stems. Don't worry about the stems right now. We will be doing two days on doing stems. So we're just playing with the flowers right now. All right, enjoy your stitching for the day.